we had the scalability issue because of the working capital. So I had to work around to find ways of growing without having to invest. I'm Sebastien Stefan, founder and CEO of LoadMe, load-me.com. We started as a digital brokerage platform for logistics, and now we're involved in SaaS that digitalizing brokers, logistics brokers around the world in exchange of equity. This is also interesting to important to be mentioned. We innovate in the business model as well, because we charge nothing to these companies that we digitalize, but we become partners, and that's how. I'll tell you later if you ask me about this. I'm originally from Romania, where I started my career in logistics, and I've also had a few businesses as an entrepreneur. 10 years ago, I moved to Dubai, where I continued my career in logistics. And I found here, a market with many opportunities. And I stepped forward, and I built LoadMe about 4 years after I came to Dubai.
So take us back to day one of LoadMe then. So how did you come up with the idea, and what made you really push forward and think, you know what, there is something here, we can make a real business of this?
Back in 2014, I was shocked to see that in Middle East there is no marketplace for transporters. We have in Europe freight exchange options since I know the .com. We have a load board for 20 or 30 years in USA, but here nothing. And that's what I did. I took this opportunity. I was the first mover, and it evolved because obviously load boards are a thing of the past, and it evolves as all the load boards around the world into digital brokerage, and then into a software integrated solutions, and then added services, and so on. Customers shaped the product, shaped us, being small company. And you have large customers like P&G, Unilever, these global companies. They shape you. You can't change them based on your product.
And it sounds like you had a number of years living in Dubai before actually launching the business. So I got to know the culture a little bit and the market itself. So tell me a bit around the process of actually launching a business in Dubai. How do you go about doing that?
Yeah, I wouldn't recommend someone just, stepping out of a plane and building a company. That would be a really, really difficult, unless it has already a company outside and then opening here a branch, but to start the freshly new idea here, it's really it adds more complexity. I think I lost the question. I don't want to get far. Can you repeat, please, the question?
Yeah, so for those looking to either expand their business to the region or to launch the business in Dubai, what was that process like for you as someone that
spent a number of years? An existing business, you want to expand it to Dubai, that's easy. That easy, you know. You have already the product. You know already the profile of your customers. You come here, you adapt that to the market. Market is totally different. I think it's really straightforward. There's a lot of opportunities, competition also, but the opportunity is there because you know, competitors are also new, like you, and the emerging market and connected to the neighboring markets. A lot, you know, English speaking employees. Everything is high-speed internet, events, you know, all in one place. Great connection for you to expand. So have here the base and then to expand and travel around. That is great. Now to come and launch here, that has advantages in terms of funding. I would say there's a lot of funds available here, and maybe it would be easier, in especially in the seed stage, to raise funds, and then you can expand or relocate to San Francisco or whatever is more relevant. I would say it's an advantage, but there is the market is very different than whatever, you know, that is a difficulty. A difficulty degree that will slow you down really, really hard if your products address the local market. Even if the products doesn't address your local market, there's still cultural aspects that you need to overcome when setting up the team and all that. I believe you need a sort of experience. First a year or two, and then you have higher chances of starting a business here.
And one of the things you mentioned is as a benefit to the region is just the number of and access to funds. So tell me a bit about your experience in fundraising in the region for LoadMe.
That is as a first step, I took an accelerator. You know, I was not experienced in this sort of ventures, tech ventures that scaled fast with the help of VC. So the accelerator is where I learned all that. Where I learned how to connect with investors, where to find them. In my view, are easy to find. There are a lot of events that are, and magazines that are specialized for this sector, and you end up knowing everyone. Then there are the neighboring countries. Saudi Arabia, obviously, but also Oman, Bahrain, Kuwait, which also has investors that are very comfortable to invest in a tech startup that is addressing issues in the local market. They really like that space, especially in the seed. And that's also, you know, exit opportunities later from conglomerates that are successful here. This is about funding, and you can see, you know, large companies getting also in the Series E funds from the region. And each government has a fund in maybe in top 10, UAE and Saudi. I think they have together three or four funds in top 10 wealth management. So, but that's of course later for exit opportunities, and they're also, because of diversification, maybe they're more interested in investing outside. But what you need in seed, Series A, it's all around the corner here. You have a coffee shop, a coffee with a analyst, and you pitch your idea.
Absolutely. And so you raised the funds for LoadMe, and then you mentioned that you actually pivoted the business. So tell me a bit around what made you make that decision, and how do you manage that with stakeholders and investors that have bought into the original idea, if you like?
Yeah. Well, I didn't say the word pivot. I think it's half, but I think it evolved. I wouldn't say, pivot will be a bigger change. We're still serving same customers. It's just the way we make money, the business model. We had to add different revenue streams. And that's where we experiment with. That's where we evolved. In order to be more scalable, we had the scalability issue because of the working capital. So I had to work around to find ways of growing without having to invest in working capital.
Makes sense.
So. The first business model was subscription based, like any market, like any load board. Subscription based, that was scalable, not scalability was the problem. Just the value of the business. You can't make a valuable business out of a subscription that addresses to a niche. So total addressable was small, while we were the value of the transaction was very high, that's when we attached to the subscription, we attached a digital brokerage where we will be collecting the money from the customer and then paying the cost of the transportation to make a margin there. So when we changed that, revenue went up, but we end up with scalability problems because of the working capital, and you fix one, you finance and. This brings me to another point. Financing your receivables, bank loans. These are more difficult, or less tools are available than elsewhere, than Europe or US. Factoring is underdeveloped. So if you have a product that addresses to large companies, obviously you're a small and medium-sized company, then you need factoring. You can't rely on loans from banks because they will be small because you're small. So factoring will help you in that case, that's how transportation companies survive in Europe. That is not available here. So that's how I end up in scalability problems. I mean, bottleneck of the working capital and Then I found a way to finance, but then I got into the next bottleneck, so on and so on until I found, and then when I wanted to expand globally, I realized that with this handbrake pulled on for this handbrake of working capital, you know, I can't go globally. I can, there's still so much untapped business in UAE that I can't go internationally and globally. And that's when I have to find a way to expand international without the working capital limitations.
Makes sense. So what's next for the business then? What are the big goals for LoadMe over the next year or so?
Well, this business model in which we get equity, we partner with an experienced logistic company that has already a business in logistics in the new territory in which we want to expand, but they're not tech. They don't have technology, and they are still in pen and paper or brick and mortar, kind of a traditional agent. And I've noticed that SaaS for enterprise is broken in general. It's broken when the enterprise is not a tech company, when they have like Atlassian and Jira. This is great. They're addressed to developers, to software companies. But all the other industries, there is technology available. There are platforms, especially construction, logistics. It's very traditional industries. They couldn't be digitalized. Just you purchase the license, there's some training, they put a lot of effort into customer success, but in the end, it's fate. The company is not digitalized. You purchase the license from Microsoft, SAP, you go through the process, but in the end, it's not. And that's why is broken, and that's why if you welcome a partner and your partner is a technology company in their DNA, and we hold the key position that are in that company that are needed in order to digitalize the company, it becomes digitalized company and disruptor, and much faster than you would achieve that with purchasing the software. And the benefits are in you know, in folds. I mean, 2x because especially in logistics, once you have and logistics brokerage where you have no assets like trucks, you know, this limitation are given about from your operation. If your operation is not digitalized, then you still have to call all the parties or the stakeholders, emails, negotiate prices with transporters, drivers. It's a total, so the benefits of digitalizing that kind of business is are really amazing. And then in 1 month, you have, I would say, the benefits of both of a tech company and of a logistic company that has already business.
So it sounds like an exciting time then. So for those listening, where can they find out more about both yourself and LoadMe?
They can contact me directly, Sebastien at load-me.com. Of course, I would give information. We're looking for partners all around the world. Today, we have here in Middle East, in North Africa and Central Africa, Philippines, and in Northern Europe. These are the regions that we covered, but you know, everything else is open, and we're scouting for partners who have experience in logistics, at least, and if they also have a running business in logistics, then it's great.